say so myself. Yay, another level up. More luck. So much luck. It's interesting that this time I have... well, mainly Merlinus and Sarah, but... I have those couple of characters that have really high luck, and I usually never focus on luck at all. It's kind of amusing. Although then, one thing in... my favorite character in... Fire Emblem 8, the Sacred Stones, the one, in terms of game numbers, the one that's after this one. Hey, don't be attacking Vaida. Not that she cares, but anyway. Fire Emblem 8, Sacred Stones, favorite character from there, is a character that has really high luck. I think most of the times I've used her, she's maxed out on luck, if I remember correctly. I might be remembering incorrectly, but I think that she usually maxes out on luck. So, that is always, always useful. It means that she's essentially impossible to hit, which is convenient, I will have to say. Who do you want to attack with? I want to attack with Lynn just in the hope that she gains more strength. Seriously, double damage and you didn't kill it. Are you kidding me? Lynn! What is this? You do double damage and you couldn't kill it. What? This is just getting sad now. Oh my gosh. Normally Lynn is a complete and total boss. But not so much this time. She's being kind of... not so boss. I mean, she's really evasive and everything, which is really useful. But she has no strength. I mean, essentially none. It's honestly... really sad. So let's see, what... oh. I guess Kanos can't go and sit in the driver's seat. I guess that's not how it works. Wait, where'd that dude... oh, he's in the blue state there. Okay, so you guys go down there. You can go up here and equip your short spear. Yeah, tactics. Because the one has light brand, so we'll attack at range. Maybe. A dude with purge could be kind of painful, but we have healers, so. Don't be attacking Sarah. I don't know why you're attacking her when she has light magic. Hey, rude. Hey, rude. Hey, that's also rude. There's so many enemies. It takes so long. Through their turns. But fortunately we can thin them out fairly effectively. Yeah, Sarah can clean up these dudes pretty easily. I like how Pint is usually the one for me who's much more the powerhouse, and yet Sarah's just the one cleaning up everyone. It's kind of amusing. Yeah, killer ballista. It's pretty killer. Not if you have, like, Rebecca or Will, or one of the really good archers, I mean, Louise, in the ballista, with the killer ballista here, that can get pretty awesome. Because they can get some really awesome critical hit chances, which is always useful. We're getting Nosferatu off of this dude, which is useful. Pretty awesome. Let's see. Who do we want to move next? Hector, go kill him. Yeah, finish him off. Finish him. And Rebecca, you can. Hey, Carell, just go kill him. Oh. Yeah. Oh, well, that's a disappointment. The only reason I attacked was for you to get a kill. And then you didn't get killed. What? It was kind of wasted. Corel. Okay, so we're gonna go heal up. No, not Hector. Kind! And then we're gonna go try and kill that dude over there. I hope that I have enough range to get to him. I'll move Rebecca last. Jafar. Doesn't really matter, just slowly move up. Don't steal any experience and do all that. Have fun! I want to just concentrate on getting Sarah experience, because she's gonna be more useful in the long run, I think. So we'll let her get all the level ups and such off of these dudes. Good grief, that luck. She's actually getting really nice stats overall. The only thing that's suffering is defense. But hey, that's okay. She has enough luck that she can evade everything. Who needs defense when you're not getting hit? I guess that's Lynn's thoughts too, which would be nice if she could actually kill something with her hits. Alright, awesome. Got the kill on him. So the purge dude is out of the way. Purge dude person. And Ken got a level up too, but only got HP. It's kind of disappointing, but nonetheless. So we got an iron ballista. Okay, so this one was just an iron ballista, but the other one is a killer ballista. And we got not a level up. That's disappointing. And a little bit over there to go to that ruins building place. Go over there and kill him. Honestly, I don't care if I'm getting hit a little bit because Vaida has enough health that doesn't really matter, and she has enough defense that doesn't really matter against these dudes. And I really want to get her as. I really would like to get her to level S with lances if possible. I don't think that's gonna happen, but I would like to. So let's see, what's in here? They're only ruins. Oh. Archsage? Who are you? You're not the Archsage, are you? I am sorry for my mistake. Wait, please, who are... I'm from Arcadia. I want to speak to the Archsage. But he's not here, is he? No, he's staying to business. I see. Do you need this?
Why would I?
We want you all to do your best for the future. Please, don't lose. If the light is strong enough, it can dispel darkness.
She's gone. Where's the mysterious girl?
Got a talisman!
Which is always useful. So that's an interesting scene. Just the random Arcadia girl. Which also means that she was probably a dragon.
Whoa. What mind-blowing madness is this?
Let's see. Rebecca, you can get off your ride now. You can get off the carousel. There's no need to ride the carousel anymore. Dart, you got hurt, didn't you? Yeah, let's heal you up.
Why not?
Okay, I'm actually taking a bit different route than I usually do on this one. Because I usually don't, send units up here much. I usually just send them on the top route here and on the bottom route here. But I don't know. I just wanted to send some dudes up through the middle this time. Let's visit.
So noisy. I thought I could escape battle here on the Dread Isle. No, I'm not interested in why you're fighting. I'm only looking for tranquility. If helping you will bring it to me, then I will lend you my power. Not that I will be that much help.
Yeah, we got the random unit from our earlier on this side chapter, Renault, a cleric wandering valor, shrouded in mystery. The bishop, he's pretty bad, actually. In my opinion, he's the highest like Pint, he is a high defense magic champion. He's a high defense bishop. But other than that, he's very mediocre. He has some good things with him. He has Light Rune, Fortify Staff, which is very useful, and will be very nice in the hands of Sarah. And he has Divine, which is always useful. But overall, he's not really worth going out of your way for, in my opinion. Any of the other bishops are better, in my opinion. See how much damage he takes and couldn't even avoid. Not that the others would, but it's just like, he's not useful. It's like the last unit. I think he is the last unit that you get in the game, and he's so useless, in my opinion. No one? What's this? Got Setslinity. Litany. A chance that increases allies' dodge for a turn. Pretty useful, actually. That's an item that you could find useful, depending on how you're playing with, Nils, / and or Ninian. Sarah, advance! Advance, Sarah! So go kill him with justice. And yeah, okay, you have Yaks, good. You advance and heal him. Renault, you stay in the back. I don't want you dying before I get to put your items away. If I have an extra lightning, I'll give it to you, but that's about it. Far, go there. Vaida, kill him. Let me just get a weapon level increase off of that dude. Although I'm running out of lance usage, which is kind of a bummer. But nonetheless, I shall prevail, quote unquote? Question mark? I shall try to prevail. Put away all your stuff, and if I have a spare lightning, I'll take it. Nope. So now you get nothing. Nothing, I tell you. The divines are all for Sarah and what's his face? Lucius. What's his and or her face? Nope. Yep, they spawn some, actually, have we even seen these dudes yet? I don't think we have. Falco Knights. An honorific bestowed upon the swiftest Pegasus Knights. Yeah, these are the promoted Pegasus Knights. I don't think I've even covered these dudes yet. Good grief, man. Good grief, man. But they're not that strong, really. This is why I like Wavern's more, except for one specific Falco Knight / Pegasus Knight that you can get. But you can't get in the normal mode of the game, you can only get in the alternate story. Which is pretty cool that they actually have an alternate story. I don't know, I find that pretty awesome. But anyway, you can only get the other, the third, actually, of the Pegasus sisters in the alternate mode of the game. And she is awesome in my opinion. She is by far the most awesome of the Pegasus Knights, in my opinion. Probably because she has the highest strength and toughness of any of the Pegasus Knights. But, you know, I like that type of unit. They are useful! Which, again, is probably why I like the Wavern Knights a lot.
to player like Vaida. She is useful. How close is she? She saw so long ago. Oh my gosh. Can you kill him, Lin? Seriously. Okay, with Meikai, you can kill him. Good grief. Admittedly, he is a general, but still, man. I mean, pull out. You have more defense still. But you did max out in skill, so I'll give that to you. With killing edge, you still probably won't do anything because your base attack probably wouldn't do any damage to them. But nonetheless, it's a attempted start. Attempted. Not necessarily successful, but attempted. That's right. Give Vaida all of your souls. Let her level up her lances off of your souls. Hey, a level up, at the very least, is useful. Always. Always useful. I love that. The Blissa doing zero damage is always awesome. Oh, and we have a dude up here, so we'll just kill him with Corel real quick. Oh, of course, when I give you an iron sword, you get critical hit, but when I give you killing edge, you don't. Rude person. I'm running out of iron lance usage. Wow, that was effective. Okay, Pent, you can stay back and take care of those dudes. Sarah, come up here. Raven, come up here. Lindis, come up here. Jafar, you might as well. Nils, slowly traverse your way towards there. Everyone else, start coming over here. Please. And thank you. Let's go up here. No, I don't care where you go, really. I really don't care. Kent, you can come into here. You two, go ahead and finish off these dudes. Whoops. Or attempt to. Allergies. They're lame. Especially since I'm usually not even very affected by them. But all of a sudden I am. Well, mainly just this year and last year a bit, I guess. It's pretty lame though. But again, they're allergies, so what do you expect besides lameness? Yeah, good job, man. Good job. Gain more magic damage. That is always useful. Right, Lin. More damage is always useful. Oh my gosh. Usually I'm never disappointed in any of the lords unless it's just my failing to get them high enough level before promoting them or something like that. But man, Lindis. Seriously. Okay, so let's get everyone. Good grief, man, you're slow. Get everyone up to Limstella, and then strike. Once the terror has left. The terror of striking at Limstella has left. Then I'll strike. Yeah, Limstella is pretty nasty. As Nurgle was saying, he's given Limstella the most powerful magic on the continent. And that's not really a joke. She doesn't have the highest stats of a magic user in this game, but I mean, okay, let me put it this way. She's a sage, but she has much higher stats than any normal sage. First off, just the HP cap
is normally 60 for any unit. She has 68. Yeah. She already has that. She has two S-level weapons, which you normally cannot do. And all of her... Well, not all of her stats, but luck, magic, defense, and resistance all have a cap of 30. Yeah. That's not normally how it works. I think magic might be a cap of 30. No, not quite that high. I think it's like 28 or something for sages. I think just druids have a cap of 30 for magic damage, I think? Question mark? But yeah, she has a cap of that in all of those. And 24 defense and 27 resistance right off the bat. That's really nasty. Really dangerous.